So at the end of that street you have the Jayanagar metro, Jayanagar metro station. So in this street you just walk a kilometer away from the Jayanagar metro. We have a straight road which is actually a little not very traffic. You can find this street very peaceful and comfortable, just a kilometer from the Jayanagar metro station. So today I'm going to Ranganna military hotel in Jayanagar. The history goes like this. The Maratha people, descendants of Maratha people, Maratha empire, they started these military hotels in the mid 17th century, in the 1650s, after 1650s. But then the military hotels which you see in Bangalore today are actually started in the early 20th century, like 1924, 1930s and 1940s. So if you see how these military hotels which you see today survived is, they usually cater to the British soldiers who are mostly Indians in Bangalore region those times in 1924-1930s. So those they were the main customers. So you see British soldiers were made up of all the different kinds of people in India. So people from different, unlike the original military hotels in the 17th centuries, these hotels were started by the Telugu speaking, Marathi speaking, Kannada speaking people all over the place in Bangalore to cater to the British officials. So I think you can say this is like the unification of the military hotels, like the unification of Indian forces, because as you can see the British forces later become the, most of the regiments of the British forces later become the Indian regiments after independence. So I'll go to the Ranganna military hotel and see if the food is as authentic as they claim it should be. Just opposite to the petrol pump. Some introduction about this Ranganna military hotel is, it was started in 1964 in Domlur and then moved to Jayanagar in 1967 as a bigger branch. So it has a lot of history behind it. It's not a hotel that started recently. So I think it's a must visit for anyone who is in Bangalore. You can see it is there's an Indian oil petrol pump and you can see opposite that there's a hotel. I think you can see this board clearly. So you can see the trademark RMH. Because you find a lot of hotels, you see a number of hotels with the same names and you don't know which one is the authentic one. So you don't want to miss it, isn't it? So got the mutton biryani, chicken kebab and kurma, and then the mutton liver is on the way, and then the leg soup is also on the way. For the kebab we have a good number of pieces, you can see the good number of pieces, and it's very crispy as well. That's what you want. But as I expected, the mutton biryani is not too much, because if you eat too much mutton biryani you cannot have the other items. Usually it's given at a moderate amount, which is quite natural. It's quite a natural thing to do. So I just put it down. So you can see how it is. You can see a lot of mutton pieces, nicely cooked pieces, all the way. And then nice kebab. another gourmand item, and two more items, liver and the leg soup are coming. So it's about time to taste, isn't it? Super. Fantastic hot. Got the mutton liver as well. It was nice. Big pieces. So the biryani is still there. One thing to note is the gravy which you get with the liver. It's very spicy gravy, and you can see the pieces, the bone, big bone. So sometimes you feel nice when you eat the bone, isn't it? Pieces of bone. Mutton bones are hard to bite, you can see the bone. I don't want to break my teeth. Might as well try it with the chicken, but not the mutton. You got a lot of pieces. They say the pizza which comes with the bone tastes better than the other ones. And it's so true here. See, big chicken pieces. And these things beat KFC and McD on any day. You can just come here instead of going there. Is it? Because the masala, the way they fry, everything is local and traditional. Unlike KFC, which is not native to us. It's good. Big piece of chicken. Three kebab pieces, nice, and fried pieces remaining, and some more liver. And then the gravy is too spicy, so I don't want to eat that. But I have the other gravy, as you can see. This gravy is there, so I have used it. And a little bit of biryani is there. So the moderate quantity of biryani, make sure that we can eat other things. We don't have to fill the stomach with biryani alone. Sometimes that happens. A lot of biryani and you don't have time to eat other stuff. So we got the soup, mutton soup. Fine. Everything. So get a view of all of the items available at hand. So we have eat mutton biryani. Have a chicken bite. Fantastic. And the soup. Super. Just kills it. And the soup is the killer, actually. You got it right. Liver pieces. So I need to give a final touch. I brought the plate inside my plate, and a few chicken pieces, and just see the soup. As you can see, the soup is yet to be completed. The mutton biryani.
mutton pieces are nicely cooked. This is a nice and crispy, very crispy chicken. Better than the KFC. Better when it is drank hot. So, fantastic feast. So I would say I should come here another day without a camera to enjoy the food even better, because so much was the fitness of the making. So surely I will come another day without my camera so that I can have a even better experience of the taste. That's the Ranganna military hotel. So to put in perspective as to how good the food is, last week I went to Shivaji military hotel near Banshankari. So I think I have a better experience overall, because the dining is the places to sit, there are more number of tables, so it's easy to find a place. And not just that one, the food itself has a very very good quality. You can just say by all the items, I can say they're perfect. What do you expect, right? I would say everyone want to visit this place so that you can have a better experience like me. So signing off for the day. Stay tuned and do subscribe.